Hello everyone, I'm back with one more video. In this video tutorial we will be learning that how we can configure the DB adapter in WebLogic. Okay, so if you want to create any of the composite or any of the project in SUA and you want to use the DB adapter in that project, so first you need to configure that DB adapter in the WebLogic console. How to do it, I'll be telling today. Okay, so as of now what I have done is I have opened the JDeveloper. I am working on SOA 12c basically. It is JDeveloper 12c and I have already run the integrated WebLogic server. So for that integrated WebLogic server, we will be going to the console page. Okay, so I am going to a browser. Just need to write console. So this is my console page. Okay, so once you are at this page, how you need to start, let me tell you. First you need to go to services. In the services, click on the data sources. So here you will be creating a data source. Just click on new and click on generic data source. In this you are giving the name of your data source. Let me tell you one thing, that I have already gone through all these processes. So basically data source and everything is already present in my local system. I am doing it once again to show you. So maybe I'll not be able to show the each and every screen as it is coming to your system, but you can correlate with it. Maybe some of the screens will not come to my system because I have already done this all the steps. Okay, so name, let's suppose we are giving, see, I have already created with test 1 2 3 and all, so let's give test 5. Okay, what is the JNDI name? This you need to give as JDBC/ whatever the name you have given. So test 5. Okay, it will be the JNDI name for your JDBC data source. Okay, now you just need to click on next. Here it is automatically showing the database driver. It is using the train driver. You do not need to change anything over here. Just click on next. And here also just click on next. Okay, so here you need to give the all the credentials of your database. Okay, so I'm trying to create the like DB adapter for Oracle database. I have already installed Oracle database 12c in this local system. So here you need to give the database name. It should be actually SID of your database. So the SID of my database is ORCL. Okay, and host name is localhost. This is the port and database user. So if you are using the database user as sys, okay, then it should be as sysdba. Okay, if you are using any another user which you have manually created, you do not need to put as sysdba. Okay, the password is this one, and this is the password for my local system. It depends on your system actually. So if you want to get all these credentials also, you can go to tnsnames.ora in your local system and you can find out what is the host name, what is the database name and what is the port for your database which you have installed in your system. You just click on next. So it is automatically coming that what is the driver class, what is the URL, what is the database username and everything. Okay, here you need to click on test configuration first. It should come as connection test succeeded. If it's not coming as connection test succeeded, you may need to change like credentials, whatever you are giving. There is some error. So go back, change your credentials, and then after completing this, click on test configuration. It should come as connection test successful. Okay, then you can go to next. Here actually, you are giving the server. Okay, so if you are working on a like a live project, so there maybe you are working on managed server. So in that case, basically the managed servers and clusters will come here. So you need to click on that. In my case, I'm working on local system. So only integrated WebLogic server is there. So I'm clicking on default server and here I'll click as finish. So as you can see, all changes have been activated and no restarts are necessary. Okay. So if again you are clicking on data sources, you can see that your data source name will basically come here. See, this all I have created. So the data source name which I have created just now, test 5, it's coming here, and this is the JNDI name for your data source. So this is the first part. Now what you need to do is go to the deployments. Okay, here everything is coming. So what you need to do is just click on customize this table and click on this exclude libraries when displaying deployments and apply. So then you will find this TV adapter in the first page itself. Otherwise you need to go for 179 like deployments and you need to press next and everything. So here you just need to click on DB adapter. In this DB adapter you need to click on configurations. Here you need to click on outbound connection pool. Okay, so here you need to create a one connection pool. Okay, so just click on new, click on this one and then click on next. Here it is asking for JNDI name. This JNDI name is basically more important. This JNDI name is for your connection pool. See, the outbound connection instances represents a connection pool. The JNDI name can be used to obtain the pool at runtime. Okay, so this JNDI name basically we will be giving in the DB adapter while we are using the DB adapter in the composite while creating the project in SOAP. Okay, so the JNDI name which you can give is EIS/ your DB then / ORCL. This ORCL is basically the SID of my database. Okay, so now you need to click on finish. See, in my case it directly came as all changes have been activated, no restarts are necessary. But in your case maybe one more window will come in which it will say that you have made configuration changes that need to be stored in a deployment plan. So basically you will get a path for your deployment plan. So the file name will be plan.xml. okay, it will be a new window. What you need to do is you just need to click OK, and in the next window you will get this all changes have been activated and no restarts are necessary. Okay, so after doing all this, if you will click on this plus button, you can see that your name has came EIS/DB/ORCL. Okay, now what you need to do is you need to click on this. It will show you the outbound connection properties. Okay, so in the outbound connection properties, here is the main thing. It is data source name. So basically you are giving the data source name which you have created earlier to the outbound connection name, to the outbound connection. Okay, so here in the property value you need to click here and see what I was telling you. As of now we have created the data source as test 5. Okay, but this is the earlier data source which I have created, so I'm not making any changes to it. In your case you need to give as test 5 or whatever the name you have given. It is basically your data source name. Okay, after giving the name you need to press the enter. If you are not pressing the enter, it will not save the value. Okay, and then you need to press on save button. So you'll get these messages: all changes have been activated and deployment plan have been successfully updated. Now only one step is left. Go to the deployments once again. Here you need to go to the DB adapter. This time do not click here, click here, then only you will get these values update. So you need to basically update the DB adapter because you have made some changes. Just click on update. Here redeploy this application using the following deployment files. See, this is all about what I am talking, plan.xml. okay, so in my case it did not came because I have done this process earlier also, but in your case you need to press on plan.xml. you will be saving this file, then only it will come to the picture. Okay, so here you just need to click on next and click on finish. Okay, so here you can see the messages: all changes have been activated, no restarts are necessary, and selected deployments were updated. So this is how you can configure the DB adapter in WebLogic console. Okay, after doing this, now if you'll go to your JDeveloper, let's create a new project. I'll not be creating the project, just to show you. So let's go to SOA project. Let's click on OK. Let's say project 2 only. Click on next, finish. So now if you will drag and drop the database adapter, this is the name, let's say whatever, test. Go to next. See, this is all about the JNDI name which we have created. This connection, if you want to add it, you can go to plus button also. You can give the connection. If the same, you see, this is the username, password, role as SysDBA, host name and SID, and this is the port number, cancel, and this is the JNDI name. Okay, so JNDI name you need to give the same whatever you have created. Let me show you. From here also you can find out. Let's select the integrated WebLogic server. In this, go to DB. Find out the DB in the down, I guess. Yes, DB. Just click on ORCL. See, EIS/DB/ORCL. This is the JNDI name which we have given. Now, if you click on next, this is all about the configuration of your database. Okay, adapter. So, I'll be creating like projects on database now. Okay. So I'll be creating 3-4 projects and making videos and posting it to my channel only. Okay, so this is how you can configure the DB adapter. So in the next videos, we will start creating the projects on database. Okay, I want to tell you one thing also, that I got 2 comments to create some videos on EDN, event delivery network, and one is on fault handling in SOA. So I'll be creating those videos as soon as possible. And one more thing I want to clear, that I'm not a SOA expert. Whatever I'm doing is based upon the my own understanding. And before creating any video, I'm doing all the tasks by myself also, and then only posting it to YouTube. If you find any errors in that, you can post a comment below in the video. It will be helpful for others. Okay. So for further videos, please subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share with your colleagues and friends. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching.